Deacon Rob and Deacon Ian, as part of God's divine plan, and as the prophet Jeremiah in our gospel just reminded you, the Lord has formed you in the womb. He has chosen you. He has called you by name. And soon, you will be ordained his priests. We rejoice with you, your dear parents and family. And we surround you this day and always with our love and our prayers. Robin E., the people here at St. Patrick and at St. Bernadette and Fuquay Verena, their first priestly assignments, are looking forward to meeting you. And they will begin to introduce themselves to you. I am so-and-so, I am so-and-so. And in time, they will begin to use other phrases to identify themselves. Phrases that reflect their spiritual dispositions and human emotions. For example, there will be times that they come to you aware of their human weakness and sinfulness, and especially in the confessional, will say these words, "I am sorry," because they are. And how blessed are you to be ordained in this year in which our Holy Father has called for, beginning December 8th, a Jubilee year, a year of mercy. And it's the hope and prayer of Pope Francis that all the faithful, including those you will seek out as diocesan priests with missionary hearts, will become ever more aware of God's great love for them and of the truth that there is no sin greater than God's divine mercy. You, soon to be ordained priests, are called in a very special way to be instruments of that mercy. Through your compassionate service, and especially in the sacrament of penance. I wish to echo the words that Pope Francis spoke to the men he ordained in April. In the name of Jesus Christ and his church, never tire of being merciful. Imitate the Father who never tires of forgiving. Ian and Rob, I'm sure the people you are going to serve will also say to you words that speak to another reality in their lives. I'm hungry. Because they are. They have discovered, especially our youth and young adults, that the empty promises of the world will never satisfy them. So they seek the truth and the nourishment that will sustain them. So how blessed are you to be ordained to preach the gospel? So pray that the gift of the Holy Spirit, through that gift of the Holy Spirit, your hard work, your preparation, will always allow your words to touch the hearts of God's people because they come from your heart. Most especially as you preach the gospel, heed those words of St. Paul today. No, we do not preach ourselves. We preach Jesus Christ the Lord. And how blessed are you to administer the sacraments, and as his priests, to celebrate daily the holy sacrifice of the Mass, so that God's people will be fed and nourished with the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the eternal gifts that satisfy their hunger and quench their thirst. I think it's so beautiful, so providential that tomorrow you celebrate your first Mass on the solemnity of the most holy body and blood of Jesus Christ. And Robin Ian, as you get to know the people you will be serving, I'm sure that at times they will say these words to you, "I'm tired." Because they are. They work hard. They try every day to be faithful to God's commands. And so many expectations and demands are placed upon our people in daily life. It was interesting to note that in his Chrism Mass homily this year, Pope Francis said that to be tired, that's a good thing. It means we're trying to be faithful to our duty. But he said it has to be a joyful, a fruitful exhaustion. And it will be. If we always remember that all we do, no matter what it is for the glory of God. And in response to the command of Jesus today, who says to all of us, love one another, sacrificially, selflessly, as I have loved you. Robin Ian, the parish of St. Patrick, the parish of St. Bernadette, like all our parishes, have countless spiritual and pastoral needs. And you are going to have to work hard. And there will be times that you might come to me and say, "Bishop, I'm tired." And I will respond, "Good." But that has to lead to the fact that you can wake up the next day renewed, energized, zeal, and joyful. And that can only happen if you're faithful to what Jesus said to you on the day of your ordination. Remain in my love. Nothing in priestly life and daily life can take over what is essential. Spending time each and every day with the Lord in the presence of the Blessed Sacrament. Praying for the grace and help you will need to be faithful to the priestly promises you're about to make, and constantly asking our Blessed Mother for her help and protection, the one to whom I entrust you this day. Robin Ian, the people of St. Patrick, St. Bernadette, and those across our diocese are looking forward to meeting you. And soon, you are going to be able to introduce yourselves to them in a new way. I'm Father Rob Schmidt. I'm Father Ian Van Heusen. Because soon, you will be ordained. And through the imposition of hands and the prayer of ordination, will be configured forever to the very person of Jesus Christ, the one who sends you forth to be instruments of his divine mercy, to feed and nourish his people with the gospel of joy and the sacraments of the church, and to show to others, especially those who are tired, that it is Jesus Christ alone who gives us rest, both now and forever. God bless you and protect you always.